especially men of status? Like, what is a man really looking for in a woman to make that man want to be in a long-term relationship, or perhaps those that still believe in it, settle down and marry that woman?
Mm-hmm.
So we'd like to hear from you from a woman's perspective, believe it or not. you step right on the hot seat.
Okay. I think my personal opinion, first let me start off, I'm not a man. So you know, it would just be sort of my personal adult woman who also like works for herself and takes care of herself and doesn't necessarily depend on anyone, man or woman. You know, so I think, you know, a lot of times, especially today, you have a lot of women that are very, let me choose my words wisely, I would say like dominant. and, you know, I think for men, especially today, you know, it's almost sort of like emasculating. To where you have a lot of women that come in and they sort of, you know, make men feel like they're not men because of certain things, because of things like, you know, oh, if I make more money than you, or, oh, if I do take care of myself and my kids, or, you know, certain things like that. And I think today women have to really kind of take a step back, especially when you're in a relationship, right? You really kind of got to step back and, you know, let men lead. Men are leaders. That's what they're supposed to do. We are supposed to follow. But I think you have a lot of women today that don't know how to do that.
Well, I'm confused, Chris. If I could just, so you're single, right? You just said you were single, right?
I'm a single mother. Yes.
And so are you single by choice? Because most single women don't have the mindset that you have, which you just stated, right?
I am single by choice. There's opportunities. I mean, they're everywhere. But I feel like me personally, not even just as a woman, as a person, I have had a lot of time to sort of grow into myself, the woman that I am today. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, I feel like there are characteristics about myself that, you know, I mean, just when you're not ready, you're not ready. I am a woman that is, you know, someone who is used to doing by myself. So, you know, I feel like I'm not really at a point where I'm ready to let a man lead, and I'm woman enough to admit that. You know, when you have a lot of women that, you know, are in situations where it's like, oh, I don't want to be alone, or, you know, I want help with certain things like financial help, or, you know, just sort of like emotional support. And I feel like as a person, not just man or woman, you got to be person enough and big enough and mature enough to admit those kinds of things, you know. And I feel like you have a lot of people that don't do that, you know. And me personally, I'm a very aware individual. I'm a very self-aware person. I know how to sort of pinpoint my flaws, and I'm a person that wants to grow in life. I mean, if you're not growing, you know, or if you're not changing, you're not growing, you know? And so, I choose to be single because I don't want to be in a situation where I'm making someone feel like less than. Like, that's never my goal ever in life. You know, and so it really comes down to that. You do have a lot of people and a lot of women who feel entitled, like, you know, a man is supposed to do this and a man is supposed to do that. And it's like, well, what are you bringing to the table to where I even feel comfortable doing this for you? You know, or can I even, you know, walk in those shoes to where I'm comfortable saying, like, you know, I'm comfortable doing this for my woman because I know that she's going to be, you know, playing her role and playing her part and wearing her shoes as well. And I feel like it's a problem. It's a problem today for sure.
So let me ask you this, Chris. So you, how many children do you have? One, two?
I have one son.
Oh, you have a son.
Mm-hmm.
All right. So, but you're not ready for a man to lead you, right? Now, his father, what's his relationship with his father?
He has somewhat of a relationship with his dad. Like, my son knows who his dad is. I'm not the kind of woman to keep my son from his father, despite, you know, controversy and despite situations that we've been in. It's just, to me, that's not my part. Like, that's not my role. He is a person. He's a human being. He has to learn the kind of people that he wants in and out of his life. And I will leave that decision to him. That's not a decision for me to make.
How old is your son?
He's 9. He just turned 9 December 22nd.
Yeah, that is a decision for you to make. He can't make an intelligible decision. He doesn't know what's best for him at the age of 9, right?
Right. So when I say that, right, I don't necessarily force a relationship, but I do allow him, you know, like, if he wants to speak with him, I'm not going to be the kind of parent that's like, you can't talk to your dad. You know, I'm not going to be the kind of person that's like, you know, I'm not going to talk bad about him or, you know, put this image in his head. You know what I'm saying? I do my part, as in I keep my son safe. I continue to take care of him. I continue to provide for him. I continue to, you know, try to guide him. And, you know, I mean, that's literally the best that I can do in that situation. I can't force him to talk to him. I'm not going to be like, yo, call your dad. You need to call your dad. Or
why not? Why not? So I have custody of my sons, right? If I think they go too long without talking to their mother, I tell them, you need to call your mother. She didn't call me, so call her anyways.
Call.
Because that's what a responsible parent does. See, it's detrimental. It's detrimental to a child, and you may not be able to understand this right now. It's detrimental to a child and very confusing when parents are not together. That's already hard enough on the child because the child believes that they've done something wrong, right? That caused that breakup initially. Even if you tell them no, a child will often think that there is some, you know, it's their fault, right? So the child, you know, and he or she needs both parents, boy or girl, right? And if they're not together, like, you know, it's all good. You're not speaking ill about him, but you still need to ensure that his father is in his life, especially, you know, he's 9. These are critical stages that you have you looked at the outcome of some of these results of not really having a good father figure in your life?
I'm one of those people. I did not have a good father figure. My son's father did not have a good father figure. And I think that's why I try not to, like, sort of make him out to be, you know, kind of what he is. I mean, and I totally get what you're saying, because it's 100% true. I agree 100%. I feel like it is very important, which is why, you know, even though we have clashing moments, you know, at the end of the day, sometimes it comes to a point to where it's like, I have to pick and choose my battles in life, right? And my son is only getting older. And so that's not necessarily a battle that I want to partake in. I don't want my son to see it as, you know, mom's always fighting with my dad and, you know, she's always arguing with him. And that's not the image that
Can I say something, sis? Mm-hmm. If you really love your son, right, you don't have to really interact with the father unless, this is what I told my son's mom. You don't communicate with me unless it's an emergency or something with my children. The relationship between you and I is done. We're never going to be together again. But if they're with you, if there's some sort of emergency, then you reach out to me. When I drop them off, when they go and visit her, I don't say anything. I don't get out. Just here's the children in my head. And I've been doing this for about 7 years. Because I don't have any kind of animosity or anything against her, but I look at the betterment of my sons, because despite even whom or what, I realize that a kid's going to always love its mother or father unless someone indoctrinate them with something to think otherwise. Yep. So not having his father in his life at these critical years typically ends up developing some sort of personality disorder. And the other thing, the other thing that you got to be concerned about is what you're teaching him is that, well, it's okay not to have that father figure in your life. So believe it or not, you may be teaching him to abandon women or to be like a father like his father, right? Because what he's learning, my father wasn't really in my life. I have to do it. And we don't teach with words, we teach by examples, right? So, but if you keep telling, if you reinforce to him, well, you know, you should see your father and so on and so forth. Like, even if, see, you and him don't have to argue. You don't have to communicate with him. Just say, well, you're going to pick up this and such time and so on and so forth, right? And even if, you know, you think it's going to be an argument, you have some sort of mediator that you just drop him off. But that father, unless he's some dope fiend or something, he needs to be in his son's life to make everything work out better there. Like, you and his personal feelings should be set aside for the sake of your son.
Oh, for sure, for sure.
Because someone's got to break the cycle, right? You say you're fucked.
Absolutely.
You didn't have one. He didn't have one. So, you know, it's time to break the cycle for the sake of your son. I think that'll make things better. And your son, you know, he'll love and respect you more for it. Because even if he's saying no, he still loves his father. A kid loves both parents. And so when parents get into these wars, they got to think of the betterment of the children. You know, how's this going to affect the children in long terms? Because he'll take that into his relationship when he gets older. Because when we get older, these things that we learn as a child don't go away. So we take this into our relationships and we put it on other people because, you know, we haven't held. So I think they, I would tell him. I literally told them, hey, call your mom. Well, she haven't called me. Call her anyways. You be the better person. You call her. That's going to teach her, and because it's going to make her feel bad, you know? Like, well, my son got to call me. Hey, just call your mom. She said this about you, Dad. I don't care. I don't want to hear what she said about me. Just give her a call. She's your mother. Don't ever talk bad about your mother.
It comes to a point where there's situations where, like, my child's father is not as simple as, you know, just let's agree on a time to drop him off and then drop him off without having to communicate. There are situations where he has, like, literally disrespected me to my son to a point where, you know, my son is like, Mom, he can't be talking about you like that to me, you know, because and he feels like that because I don't talk about him like that to my son. So when it's like when you're, you know, or he'll do certain things like where it's like, okay, well, it's your day to get him and I'm ready to drop him off, you know, but all of a sudden it's like, oh, well, I have to do this or I have plans. I have to do this and that. And it's like, well, we had an agreement. You got to stick to the agreement. You know, if we're agreeing to do things on this term, there shouldn't be any issues if you've already planned ahead or we've already discussed this, you know, and then it's like if I have to go to work. You know, because I primarily care for my son. So, you know, there have been instances and it just kind of gets to the point where, you know, because like my son is 9 years old. And so it gets to the point where it's like, OK, I can't force you to be a father, you know, just like you're not forcing me to be a mother. I do this for my son because I love him. And I took this blessing from the Lord and I decided to take up this role as a parent. You know, no one forced me to do it. I do it because I chose to do it, you know? And so there's situations where, you know, at the end of the day, it's like, I as much as I want you to be a father to your son, I can't take, you know, being belittled and degraded and disrespected all the time just so that you can be a father to your son. You know, at some point as a human, I have to show him, you know, you have to stand like that. You can't just let anybody, it doesn't matter if it's just family, you know, or loved ones, you can't just let anybody treat you a certain type of way because that's your mother or your father or your brother or your sister, mother of your child. You get what I'm saying?
You don't have to be around him. So I'm kind of confused here. Huh? So you don't have to be around him. Like your son could be just
right, so dropped. We tried the mediating. We even tried to where, you know, it was I'll drop him off at someone's house and then you come pick him up at that person's house, you know, and then you drop him back off and I'll pick him up with them and stuff like that. And it started getting to situations where someone else will be picking up my son and he doesn't want to tell me who's picking him up. And I don't know where my son is or, you know, who he's with. And then it comes to the point where, well, what if something happens? Whenever he's with me, you know who he's with. He's never with a stranger or just some random person out of nowhere, you know, and it would come situations like that. Let me tell you guys something, because I feel like I am a mother, you know, who has tried so many avenues in so many ways to have like a cordial relationship with the father of my child for my son, not because of my personal feelings and not because of just because he is a boy and I am not. I am a woman. I'm not a man. So there are things that I feel like he needs to learn from his father, you know, and I never wanted my son to lack in those things, you know. There's so many times, man, where it just gets so out of control. At some point, somebody has to like take a step back, like, you know, at the end of the day, if you continue to make these decisions, it's just your decisions. I can't continue to, in a sense, it's sort of like I'm allowing him to continue this behavior if I continue to feed into it. You know, I'm losing the word here. I'm losing the word. It's like I'm letting him
do. You think you're enabling him?
I'm enabling him. Thank you so much, brother. That is exactly the word. It's like I'm enabling him to behave like this. You know, if I continue to, you know, like just let him do these things. I mean, and that's not. I don't want that to be the ideal. You know, because it's not okay for you to show him disrespecting a woman, let alone the mother of your children. You know what I'm saying? Like at the end of the day, I did give this kid life and I do take care of him primarily, you know, and I do try my best to teach him what I can teach him as an adult, as a parent, you know, but at the end of the day, if you're not taking on that responsibility either, I can't force you to do it, you know, just like no one's forcing me to do it. So there's been so many situations where I have tried my best to help him be in his son's life, and just to constantly sort of be like disrespected and looked down upon, to be, you know, taken stuff is, you know, I'm being used and taken for granted, then, you know, criticized when I need help for certain things. I mean, at some point it's like, you know what, I would rather just kind of do it on my own. And if you choose to be a part of his life, I won't stop you. You have that option. You've always had that option, but I'm not gonna force you. And I'm not gonna make it seem like it's something that you just absolutely have to do, because you took on this role as well. We both took on this role. And so it's like, you know, it's like a tug of war sometimes, you know? And I feel like speaking just like as a single parent in general, you can't really, like, I don't think of it like me keeping him from him, or, you know, me telling him that it's okay for his father not to be there, because that's not the case. It's just at the end, it's like me, like sort of demanding a certain level of respect that I already give to you, despite everything that we go through, you know, and despite everything that we've been through, I'm still giving you that, showing you that level of respect as his father, because that's who you are.
So let me ask this, Chris. So, how long have you and the father not been together?
We haven't been together since my son was about a year old.
So for like 8 years.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. So, how long was you and the father together prior to your son being born?
Not very long. We were only together for 2 years, when I got pregnant with my son.
So, and what do you, What do you think caused the separation? Were you guys married, or it was just a relationship?
No, we were just in a relationship.
So what caused the separation? Because at some point, for you to be attracted to this guy, you give him your most sacred part, you let him impregnate you. At some point, things had to be going well. So at what point did things begin to turn sour?